Hello, my old friends. It's nice to have all of you here today. I'm Michael Zhang.
And I'm Tony Shi. Now you're watching Our World on Channel 1, CCTV. Today we are going to talk about landscape painting in Western and Chinese tradition.
Firstly, we are going to talk about the similarities between them. As we can see, both Chinese and Western landscape painters mostly focus on nature, such as sky, clouds, mountains, sea or river. Occasionally, human activities and buildings are depicted as a relatively small part of the entire painting.
Although Chinese and Western paintings do share some similarities, the differences between them are more important, and that is the main topic we will discuss today. There are three main differences between Chinese and Western landscape painting: the perspective, the use of color, and the method of expressing.
As you can see, this group of paintings mainly shows the difference on perspective. When we observe events ringing in an oak forest, our eyes are easily led by the two rows of trees from foreground into the background, and we end up our viewing right in the middle of the painting. It is easy for us to tell the composition of the painting and follow it, because the painter uses perspective. It depicts the trees in decreasing size from front to the back, and he also uses vanishing point to help us view the painting as he intended.
Chinese painting, however, is different from Western landscape painting. When we first appreciate this landscape painting painted in Tang Dynasty, our eye will stay on the painting for a while to allow our mind to find a way or order to view it. Because unlike Western painters, Chinese painters usually do not apply the concept of perspective in their painting. Thus, there is no vantage point in the painting to guide the viewer. So it might be confusing and a little uncomfortable when first viewing this Chinese painting. But when we look at it more carefully, we will notice Chinese landscape painting actually is pretty interesting. Instead of depicting the landscape in a clear composition, Chinese painters prefer to use a different depth of color to express the mountain in different distances. The lack of perspective in this painting also helps the observer to think and imagine while they are viewing. Chinese painters, as well as the art education system, encourage people to think differently and have their own idea about art. This painting perfectly demonstrates their philosophy.
The second difference between Chinese and Western landscape painting is the use of color. In Western painting, the painters use various colors to depict the nature. For example, in this painting by Jean-Baptiste, the sky is depicted in blue, the surface of the lake is depicted in white, the house and forest, as well as their reflections on the surface of the lake, are depicted in yellow, brown, and green. The human figures are depicted in red and yellow. So you can see the color usage is very rich in Western painting.
On the contradictory, Chinese painters usually only use one color in their landscape painting, and we can call this kind of painting monochromatic. For example, in this painting finished during Tang Dynasty, the painter uses black ink only on a piece of white paper to depict all this scene. The trees, mountains, and bridges are depicted in black. The river and sky are depicted in white. There are two reasons why most of Chinese landscape painting are monochromatic. Firstly, to draw with only black ink is a tradition in Chinese art since Tang Dynasty. Secondly, the painters prefer to use simple color to express complex scenes, because it can provide the observers more space to think, instead of just simply view the painting and accept painter's fault.
The third difference between Chinese and Western landscape painting is the method of expressing. Chinese and Western painters choose different ways to express the meaning of their paintings. In this He Wei by John Constable, it is easy to see the painter focus more on depicting the nature in a realistic or a scientific way. For example, in this painting, he emphasizes chiaroscuro, or the contrast between light and shadow. We can see the shadow of the trees and the little house, and we can also see the reflection of the trees on the surface of water. Everything in this painting is depicted in a way that people usually look at in their daily life. In other words, the painter paints whatever he sees in his eyes. By painting realistically, the observers can see exactly the same landscape as the painter sees.
Chinese painters, however, concern more about the spirit of landscape rather than the appearance. This painting was finished during Tang Dynasty. It is easy to tell that the painter depicts the mountain in an abstract form. The brushes' strokes are visible and distinctive, instead of depicting the detail and smoothly demonstrate the light and shadow, which Western painters usually do in a traditional way. Chinese painters simplify the complex natural landscape and only shows the observers the very nature and spirit of the natural scene. In this way, the observers will have more space to think out of the painting and understand the same artwork in different ways. And that is the philosophy of Chinese art. Everyone has their own understanding and feeling about art.
These are the three main differences between Chinese and Western landscaping. Besides these differences, there are some interesting facts about Chinese and Western painting, such as the material used in traditional Western painting are oil and canvas, whereas Chinese painters usually use ink and wet paper as conventional material. The other interesting fact is that most of Chinese painters are calligraphers. They like to combine the calligraphy in the painting to express the meaning of the work more clearly. However, Western painters do not add calligraphy in their paintings.
Okay, everybody, I know you miss us, but we have to say goodbye. Don't be upset. We'll meet with you at the same time tomorrow at 7 p.m. to continue our exploration in the art world. Bye.
See ya.